Why do we tear up? Well, the most obvious reason is that when our eyes are irritated or dry, tears help lubricate them. Now, when it comes to tearing up, a lot of animals do it. Humans, dogs, even crocodiles shed tears. But did you know that tearful, emotional crying is, as far as we know, unique to us humans? The real question is, why do we do it at all? Do we get anything out of crying? It's kind of weird that liquid comes out of our peepers at all. I'm Erica Bergman, and we're wired that way. Why do we, humans, cry emotionally with tears? The short answer is, we're still figuring it out. But there's lots of theories. Let's take a look at human babies. While a lot of other animals are born with the ability to protect and take care of themselves, humans are basically helpless blobs. Crying is their only recourse to let the adults around them know they need something. Maybe we never really outgrow an occasional bout of helplessness. When we get overwhelmed emotionally, we cry, which sends signals to other humans that we need some help coping. This makes sense since we cry when we feel really extreme levels of emotion like sadness or joy, rage, and surprise. If our tears are a sign to others that we need a little empathy, it helps explain why emotional crying is uniquely human, since connecting with others defines us as a species. In fact, our emotional tears have a different chemical composition than the tears we get from, say, chopping an onion. One study in the 1980s suggests emotional tears contain more protein, which makes them stick to our faces longer and run down our cheeks more slowly. This makes the tears more likely to be seen by others. So we might cry to connect with other humans, but there are other science folks out there, and one suggests that our tears are more about manipulation. When we're young, we realize crying has a powerful effect, and it neutralizes other people's anger. Someone confessing to guilt might cry to gain forgiveness from the person they hurt. This could be why tears are an integral part of lovers' quarrels. A small study even postulated that the tears of women contain a chemical substance that inhibits male libido and aggression. Then, of course, there's the good cry theory, my favorite. You've probably heard people say at some point in your life that crying is good for you. Scientists are divided on this. Some say there's no difference between letting it all out and holding back tears. When it comes to your emotional or physical well-being, crying has no immediate impact. However, some other science people have shown that while crying doesn't give you instant relief, there's a chance that it can help you feel better 90 minutes after you cry. And that people who don't cry at all are more likely to feel negative, aggressive feelings like rage and disgust. Why do you think we cry? Let us know your tear-jerking theories in the comments below. Or share your best and weirdest crying moments with us. So there you have it, the science of crying. We still have plenty to discover, but that's all we've got. Oh, don't cry. Or do. Maybe it's good for you. After all, we're wired that way.